folks. So what do your eyes see today? There's a lot of news stories you could read. There's a lot of negative around you and all around me. And our eyes see that. It's not like you have to shut out your eyes from what's there, but not focus them on that. We talked about the power of imagination on Sunday.
Yeah.
And we want to unpack that in this particular, you know, segment. Imagination is a very powerful starter for the best things or the worst things.
Yes.
And that's key for us to understand.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's not about whether or not you have an imagination. It's how to focus it, how to direct it, how you're going to use it.
Yeah. If you view it as a starting line to a race, right, you're either going to have a race of worry or a race of faith.
Exactly.
Right. Yeah. There's a scripture, let's just read this quickly, that we just said on Sunday, 2 Corinthians 4:18, and it says this, we set our eyes not on what we see, but on what we cannot see. Well, okay, it's basically saying all the headlines that your eyes are captured with today, that's what you can see.
Yeah.
But that's not what's going to last. What we see will last only a short time, but what we cannot see will last forever.
Mm.
So the headlines of your life, headlines of society, headlines of everything, our eyes get captured.
Yeah.
But it's saying, actually, those things won't last.
That's right.
So there's an inner eyes that need to capture what is God's work? What is God doing? The things that will last.
That's right.
The kingdom of God at work in this world and in your life and in your family and all that he's using in your life, all he's gifted you with, the opportunities he's got, the breaths you're breathing. It's amazing, right?
It is amazing.
Eyes hear, see that.
Yeah.
Eyes hear, don't readily see that.
No, no. And the more that we pay, I know for me anyways, the more I'm focusing on those headlines and what these eyes see, the bleaker it looks, right?
Yeah.
It looks almost impossible. It looks really tough. And I was talking to a lady this weekend who just said, she was in her 70s, and she just said, you know, people my age are getting worried. The people I'm talking to, we're getting worried. And and I was just thinking, you know, I haven't been, you know, consumed with fear. There's moments where things concern me, but I was just thinking, yeah, that's where your eyes are fixed. If I was just focusing on these headlines and what's right here, I'd be feeling that way too.
And that is where why it's a common thing today. Everybody's experiencing basically the same challenges and so on with this, right?
Yeah.
But imagination sets a journey. The journey of worry and the journey of faith are totally different.
Yeah.
But just talk about the journey of worry for a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Like worry and concern are quite different.
Yep. Yeah, those are two very different things. Concern is set in the reality of, yes, this is happening, but I don't have to allow myself to be sucked in completely, consumed by it. Worry is, it's like this snowball. It just can get bigger and bigger and bigger, and things get out of control.
Yeah.
The end point can become like the worst case scenario, like really quick.
Yeah.
So we would say concern is dealing with the facts of what you're dealing with.
Right.
Yes.
But worry requires your imagination.
It sure does.
Exactly.
Yes.
Right?
Yep.
It's got to, because what worry is, it's not actually dealing with reality. Worry is stepping beyond the reality and creating scenarios.
Scenarios that could maybe happen down the road, but they become bigger and bigger and more in your own mind, more and more
realistic. Now that robs us.
It absolutely robs us. It takes us right out of any possibility for hopefulness. It just narrows our perspective right on what these issues are and what could happen and what's probably going to happen, and just takes our perspective into a very narrow and negative place. Fruitfulness is not happening.
It's like wearing blinders, hey?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah.
And the faith of the Christian is not a faith that's just anchored into one change sometime in, you know, down the road where there's this objective that all of a sudden happens.
No,
the faith of the Christian is first a journey of faith.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
So the journey of faith, although you have these issues, you have this panorama in life. We all have such a panoramic life, but often people don't see it.
Yes.
They only see this issue.
Yeah.
And if this changes, well then I'm back in control and life's okay and I'm safe.
Yeah.
Except the reality is, once that issue's gone, okay, well, then there's another backup issue coming your way, or there's already several issues. You're just focused on the one, right?
And that's why it's important that our faith journey is about the journey and not just about the result, because the result is going to be this tiny little portion of what we experience in our life. But the journey itself is what's going to consume most of our time in our life. So,
and it's going to retain your panorama.
Yeah.
You can breathe in difficult yes. situations.
Absolutely.
You can enjoy, you know, look, I might have a worry. Okay, I got a worry at work.
Yeah.
If it concerns you, yeah. just consumes you, and now you give pictures to that, and mm-hmm. it's gone to worry. Now try to live panoramically with your family.
That's right. You're at home. That's what you're thinking about. That's what's gripping you. Life around you continues to go on, but you can't enjoy it. You can't get the beauty out of it. You can't.
Yeah, you're gonna start snapping on your family and
yeah,
you know, being on edge all the time.
Worry's robbing you.
Worry's
and,
robbing.
By the way, robbing others, right?
Absolutely.
So it's very important that you retain this panorama. That's only done because you choose a journey of faith mm-hmm. and you use your imagination to kick off that journey, not yes. kick off the worry.
Yes.
Because your imagination is going to attach to your problem and say, I get a problem. Mm-hmm. My imagination will attach to it, no question.
Yes.
It's which way is it going to take me?
That's yep. right.
Right?
Yeah, absolutely.
And that's a big choice.
It is a big choice. And I think it does require discipline, right? Because you really do, everything coming at us right now, it would tend to want to bring us towards that fear journey as opposed to that faith and freedom journey.
Well, yeah, I'd say one is much easier to give into than the other.
Because, yes.
Oh, for sure.
Because one requires just your own trying to control everything and the other requires kind of hands off.
One only requires one sight.
Really, it does, yeah.
Faith requires both.
That's right.
Worry only requires you to see
That's
with
right.
these.
Yeah,
yeah, absolutely.
Right. Faith requires you to see with this and this.
Mm-hmm.
That's why it's easier.
That's right.
So, my brothers and sisters, in James 1, verse 2, it says, when you have many kinds of troubles, is that our world right now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Many kinds.
That might be your life for this Christmas. Okay. Many yeah. troubles. You should be full of joy.
What?
Okay. The two ideas seem very counterintuitive.
Yeah. Yeah. Good thing we don't just park it there.
Absolutely.
You should be.
Isn't that, you know, the should is such a powerful word. Most of the time we treat it as such a negative. You should, you know.
Yeah.
But in this case, this is really true.
Yeah. Yeah.
He's saying that word is a choice word. It's saying you should be. I mean, you
don't
should
have
do
to
this.
Be. You don't have to be, but.
You don't have to go this other way. You can do this. You
yeah.
should be full of joy. Well, I've got all kinds of troubles and I should be full of joy.
Yeah.
How's that work? Imagination's a kickstarter to it.
Yes.
Choose faith as your journey, not worry as your journey.
Yes.
Look with both eyes. Do the extra work of faith to
work.
See with both sets.
That's right.
And then he says, you should be full of joy because you know that these troubles test your faith. Not whether you have it.
Mm-hmm.
You have it. You have it. I have it. She has it. He has it. Hey, we all got faith.
We got faith.
It gets tested.
Yeah.
What is being tested is, are you going to use it
yeah.
for the should?
Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
I don't like
to.
Tests.
Yeah.
Me neither. But
right?
I like to pass tests.
Yeah.
I like to do good at tests.
It really tells us that when it goes to the scripture, these troubles test your faith. It's saying, are you going to take the journey of faith?
Mm-hmm.
What are you going to use your imagination? And the imagination tells you which journey you're on.
That's right.
Whatever your pictures are right now about the issues of your life tells me exactly
yes.
whether you're on the worry or trail
yeah.
or whether you are on the faith trail.
Mm-hmm.
So
Absolutely.
I know in my life, I can decipher that in half a millisecond.
Yeah.
You know, I just have to look at the pictures that are driving me.
Yeah.
yeah.
And if I'm using my imagination, that way I'm on the worry trail.
That's yeah. right.
And the good news is you don't have to stay there.
No.
Like
no.
right now you can make the change.
Yeah, absolutely. I know last week I actually came to you with a panic situation almost and I was worried about it. And we sat down and imagined what it could be and what good could come from it and how we could make this a positive. And it was that quick, right? It went from like, oh, to, oh.
Yeah. I've never done that before.
No.
No. So, yes.
He's
so,
perfect.
So when you hit the times of your troubles, mm-hmm. it's saying it's going to test your faith, saying choose faith. Choose.
Yeah.
And how do you do that? What's your choice? My imagination. That's how I choose faith. I change the picture setup.
Exactly.
Now I'm choosing faith. I'm going to take the journey of faith, and then it's going to give me something else called patience. And this will give you patience. What does that mean? It means I'm not going to just be focusing here, because what's the opposite of patience?
Impatience and what control. You just want to control.
You just want to control, get through this
control
as quickly
the outcome,
as possible.
Control the journey. Yeah.
Yeah, and it narrows off the possibilities, and it makes the journey very exhausting and not good.
Steals your joy. Yeah. Impatience and worry walk hand in hand, which you're trying to control the world, and you can't even control, you know.
Yeah. Exactly, and it robs you of what the journey
can produce. Yeah.
So everything, as Angela said, gets drawn into this one focal point, and all energy is going into that. That's what worry does, because it seeks control of your life.
Yeah.
You have to change up the picture set, get back your panorama. God's got this. If you really believe by faith God has this, you can breathe in your whole panorama of life.
Yeah.
He's got that problem at work. I'm breathing at home.
Yeah.
I'm sleeping. You really have chosen faith. It's pictures that kick off that process. And then he says, let your patience show itself perfectly in what you do. So he's saying, once you are patient, now you just carry it out by action.
Yeah.
Now you just go and do what you need to do. You don't have to do everything, because God's got to do a lot of stuff with our problems.
Yeah.
So it's like, here's what I can do.
Do what you can do.
And I go and do that.
Yeah. I remember when we were studying Paul, and so much of it was about endurance, right? And you're kind of thinking, like, I want to have that endurance in my race and my walk with God. Like, this is the key. Paul couldn't do it all, but he had great faith and great imagination in what God could do and a great perspective of what he could do.
So the sign that you're passing the test of your faith is your patience level.
Yeah.
And if you got a patience level that says, no, God's got it. Mm-hmm. And every time worry wants to grab your pictures and take you this way, you say, no, I'm not going with your pictures.
Yeah.
I'm sticking with these pictures.
Yeah.
God's got it.
Yeah.
And I'm leaving it with God.
Yes.
You have this patience because God's got it.
Yeah.
And if you got that patience, then it ends up in your actions. All your actions, you can live all over now.
Yeah.
All your actions aren't just
controlled
towards here.
Yeah.
I can look after all of these areas too and live out here. That's your actions. That's your life. Then you will be perfect and complete, meaning mature, and will have everything you need. Then it goes into wisdom. But if any of you needs wisdom, you should ask God for it. Now, I'm not going to take a lot of time on this, but basically, simply this. You cannot get God's wisdom if you do not have the journey of faith.
Yeah.
That's right.
Because impatience takes you out of the game of receiving wisdom from God.
That's right.
I got to solve this. I got to do this.
Yeah. Puts it all back in your strengths and your wisdom.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And how do you get God's wisdom?
Being patient.
Be patient.
Yeah. Imagining the faith journey and walking through it.
And then God comes along and he can drop wisdom in and say, okay, I'll give you wisdom for your panoramic life, and here's wisdom for this problem too. Here's what you do today with this.
Mm-hmm.
Here's what you do today with this problem at work. Here's what you do today with the problem in the business. Here's what you do today with the problem in the family. Here's what you do today with the problem in your health. Here's what you do today with the problem in your finance. Here's what you do now.
So
here's my wisdom. Because the wisdom flows down faith into your life.
Yeah.
When you pass the test of faith, I keep my pictures on faith, on panoramic. I get wisdom. I have everything I need for meeting life as it comes.
Yes.
Now I can attack anger. Now I can attack all the stuff that wants to control me in the native. Keep your pictures set. Have joy. Understand the power of your imagination. You may need to go back.
Yeah.
In your points where you've right now in troubles and you've lost your strength, you've lost joy, you've lost this panoramic view, you're not breathing out here. Go back to your picture set and change your journey to one of faith, because it's your pictures that will change your journey. Give God ownership by owning good pictures that put him in charge, that trust him, that give him outcomes, that give him you and your struggles. I promise you, you will get strength and joy back. Go down that journey. The power of your imagination, eh, guys?
Mm.
Wow.
Wow.
God bless you. Merry Christmas.